Bengaluru was witness to Karnataka Bandh that had been called demanding the implementation of Dr Sarojini Mahishi report. While certain parts of the city witnessed protest, a large part of Bengaluru remained largely unaffected. Here's a lowdown on what transpired on Karnataka Bandh.
It was a day of action for the various pro-Kannada organizations that were keen on the implementation of the Sarojini Mahishi report, preparing to have their demand of getting job reservations for Kannadigas fulfilled. The pro-Kannada activists, supported by several other organizations, geared up for the day ahead. However, the first shots of the protest began on the outskirts of the city, where several protesters gathered during the early hours of the day. Protesters set fire to tires on Hosur Road close to Attibele, while another group also tried to block the roads by setting fire to tires on the Nice Road. Meanwhile, the police too started their preparations well in advance. Close to 180 rowdy sheeters were taken into preventive custody by the North Division Police. Pro-Kannada activist and the president of the Karnataka Rakshana Vedike, Praveen Shetty, was also detained at his residence as a preventive measure. In addition to this, a massive security cordon was put in place at the Krantivira Sangoli Rayanna station, from where the protest march was scheduled to commence.
We are seeing a lot of security arrangements, not only at the Sangoli Rayanna railway station, but also across the city. DCP West, Mr. Ramesh Bannett, is here. Sir, first and foremost, you have also gone ahead and given permission for a protest rally, which will be held from the Sangoli Rayanna railway station towards the Freedom Park. What security arrangements are in place?
So, no protest. Actually, we have given permission from the railway station to the Freedom Park.
Okay.
So, actually, they have given Mr. Nagesh and the Murthy from the two organizations, they have given a request for having procession and protest in Freedom Park. So we have permitted sufficient staff we deployed. You know, we have got staff from outside also, and KSRP, City Armed Reserve, and extra home guards also we got. So we deployed, and since morning 4 o'clock we are on the road. We are doing continuous patrolling in my jurisdiction.
Meanwhile, DCP Chetan Singh Rathod too undertook a review of the security arrangements along the protest route. However, at Anand Rao Circle, pro-Kannada activists attempted to shut down hotels and eateries. However, the police who had been deployed there quickly intervened, and this led to heated argument between the two groups. But Nagesh had this to say.
ಅವ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ದ ಹೌದು ಸರ್ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನಾನು ಮುಚ್ಚುತ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ಟೀ ಕೊಡಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ಟೀ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಮುಚ್ಚುತ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್ ಇವತ್ತು ನಿಮಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಕನ್ನಡದ ಮಕ್ಕಳೋಸ್ಕರ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಈ ಒಂದು ಹೋರಾಟಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಕೂಡ ದನಿಗುಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಇಲಾಖೆಯವರು ಏಯ್ ನೀನು ಮುಚ್ಚಬೇಡಪ್ಪ ನೀನು ತೆಗಿಯಪ್ಪ ನೀನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ತೆಗಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ
Meanwhile, a section of the protesters met Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa at his residence in Dollars Colony and asked the Chief Minister to implement the report during the upcoming budget session. Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa assured to look into the matter. Despite the assurance, starting off from Krantivira Sangoli Rayanna station, the protesters headed towards Freedom Park in a massive rally. Along the way, the protesters garlanded the statue of freedom fighter Sangoli Rayanna and continued their march. The rally finally reached Freedom Park. However, it was reported that the number of protesters had dwindled by then, but whoever remained were determined to see their demands fulfilled.
So let us go ahead and speak to the protesters over here. One of us who is here with us, who's going to tell us, so what is the next step forward? Do you think this today Bandh was successful?
Yeah, what we called Karnataka Bandh today is totally successfully done. And we are planning today, so we will give 3 days time for our Chief Minister. If he is not going to announcement that Dr. Sarojini Mahishi worthy what we are protesting that, we will protest again, Chief Minister also.
ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಶಿವಸೇನೆ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಅಧಿಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅಧಿಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದು 24 ಗಂಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಸ್ಥಳೀಯರಿಗೆ 75% ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂಥ ಸ್ಥಳೀಯರಿಗೆ ಉದ್ಯೋಗವನ್ನು ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಆದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಸಚಿವರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಕಾನೂನಿನ ತೊಡಕುಗಳಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಧ್ರ ಮತ್ತು ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ಇವೆರಡು ರಾಜ್ಯಗಳು ಭಾರತ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲೇ ಇರೋದು, ಅದೇ ಪಾಕಿಸ್ತಾನದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಮೆರಿಕದಲ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಾನೂನು ತೊಡಕು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಾನೂನು ತೊಡಕು ಬರುತ್ತಂತೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಈ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಮೈಸೂರು ವರದಿಯನ್ನು ಜಾರಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು.
ದ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕನ್ನಡ ಒಕ್ಕೂಟ ಸಂಘ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಟು ವಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಫೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಸ್ಟ್.
ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂದೇಶ ರಾತ್ರಿನೇ ತಲುಪಿದೆ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಿಗೆ. ಅವರು ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳೇಳಿದ್ರು, ನಾನು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅವರು ಬನ್ನಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಆದರೆ ಬನ್ನಿಂಥ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಯಾರೂ ಕರೆದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಬಂಧನ ಯಥಾಸ್ಥಿತಿ ನಾವು ಬಂಧನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವು. ಇವತ್ತು ಬಂಧನ ಒಂದು ಹಂತಕ್ಕೆ ತಲುಪಿದೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಎಚ್ಚರಿಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದೆ. ಇನ್ನೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾಳೆಯಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮ ಏನು ಧರಣಿ ಸತ್ಯ ಮುಂದುವರಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ಬಂದು ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗಿದೆ, ಸರ್ಕಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಅರಿವಾಗಿದೆ. ಇದು ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಕಿಡಿಗೆ ಹಚ್ಚಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಮುಂದೆ ಇದು ಬೆಂಕಿಯಾಗಿ ಪರಿಣಮಿಸಲು ಎರಡು ಮಾತಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಕನ್ನಡದ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಉದ್ಯೋಗ ಕೊಡಿಸೇ ಕೊಡಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಸರೋಜಿನಿ ಮಹಿಷಿ ವರದಿ ಜಾರಿ ಆಗೋ ತನಕ ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಹೋರಾಟ ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ.
Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa to assure to take the matter to a logical end but also explained his limitations.
ಇವತ್ತೇನು ಸತ್ಯಾಗ್ರಹ ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ, ಆ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೂ ಸಹ ಕೆಲವು ಪ್ರಮುಖರು ನನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರು. ನಮ್ಮ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರಿಗೆ ಉದ್ಯೋಗ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಎರಡು ಮಾತಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಯಾವ ಇತಿಮಿತಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರತಿಪಕ್ಷ ನಾಯಕರ ಜೊತೆಗೆಲ್ಲ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನೇನು ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕತೆ ಮಾಡಿದೆ.
Meanwhile, here's what happened in the rest of the city. With the Airport Taxi Association extending their complete support to the Bandh, taxi services to the airport was largely hit. Trains and metro services too operated as usual. However, commuters who arrived in this city faced difficulties in getting an auto or taxi as the autos and cabs refused to ply.
ತುಂಬ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ಇದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು, ಮೊದಲೇ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾಯಿತು. ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೂ ಇರಲ್ಲ, ಆಟೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಟೈಮಿಗೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ಕೋಬೇಕು.
Only a handful of auto rickshaw drivers dared venturing out. With fewer commercial vehicles on the road and many preferring to avoid the bandh, traffic too was minimal in the otherwise congested roads. Meanwhile, the BMTC buses plied as usual. However, owing to the bandh, the passenger turnout was minimal. Interestingly, the BMTC staff who reported for duty at the Kempe Gowda bus station were in for a pleasant surprise when a group of pro-Kannada activists distributed roses to them. The activists thanked the staff for reporting to duty despite being a bandh and distributed roses to the drivers and conductors. Schools and colleges functioned as usual. School buses and parents were seen dropping the students as always.
So this is one such school in the city which has had no impact whatsoever due to Karnataka Bandh. But let us go ahead and speak to one of the faculty members over here, Mr. Naveen, who's going to give you an overview about what exactly is happening at the school on this day. So Mr. Naveen, as we all know, the schools are functioning normally, but with the parents, has there been any kind of, you know, wariness in respect to the bandh, and if, you know, any violence is caused, are they worried about it?
Nothing. As per daily routine, everything is going well and the students are there coming in time and the parents also are not panic to come here. Everything is functioning well. Our school transportation is well and the private vehicles are all, they are doing well. As per this one, there is no train of any trouble or anything. As per time, the school has started. Assembly has started, the teaching faculties have come, everything is fine, ma'am.
The PU exams too were conducted as per schedule.
So they told it's a normal functioning in the college and it will be scheduled on Thursday's timetable. So there was no changes basically in our college timetables, and the exams are exams which are scheduled today are being conducted.
But the highlight of the day was the city's moviegoers. Irrespective of the bandh, moviegoers queued up at the theaters which functioned as usual.
Namage en thondre agilru madam ella start aithe almost ella bus start adavu auto nu start adavu en problem
illa amel ille movie theaters ella open aida
ha open idave
ticket to issue martidare
ha ticket kottidaralla already nodakanta bandavre.
Even the city's malls remained open but with adequate protection. For the rest of the city's commercial establishments, it was life as usual. In all, while the bandh was in effect in the city, Bengalurians remained largely unaffected by the bandh. Prajwal and Amrita for News 9, Bengaluru.